Hello everyone, it's Jess Hartz. Today we're building the Diagonal Modern. So first, yes, I am using a mod, and that mod is Tool. And don't stress, you won't need this mod to download the house. It's marked as not using CC, and everything will be fine. I've tested it, Kate Emerald has as well. Yeah, it's such an amazing mod, but that's how I got those like diagonal walls in the thumbnail. But yeah, this was honestly such a fun build, and it's so nice flexing my creative muscle again. I haven't been able to do a lot of that since the beginning of October due to trying to recreate the houses from movies and shows. And like, don't get me wrong, it's so much fun, but a lot of work goes into them. Like for the Addams Family, I had to take hundreds of photos and watch both of the movies, which does cut a chunk out of your day, let alone watching the Sabrina show again to take another few hundred photos. But I always end up feeling so proud and happy with the outcomes. Plus, not to mention, like, pretty much writing an essay every time I do those videos. But something I also don't do is have fun with editing as much with those builds. One, because so much already is happening in those videos, and I don't want to create a sensory overload, if that makes sense. But it's also because it takes a lot of time. Some of you might have noticed I don't edit my speed builds like the traditional, I guess, format. So I take ages building, right? I also spin the camera around a fluff load, and I've made sure I don't do that as often in this build whilst furnishing because I find that quite annoying. But when I'm editing, I like to cut out a lot of the pauses and me being an idiot whilst building because the video would just be so long. Like, I'll spend ages just like choosing a specific plant, and I'm certain you guys don't want to watch me for like 30 seconds choose a pot plant. Like, that'd be really annoying. It's like how I don't always film the furnishing of the bathrooms because, well, it's like a makeup tutorial. They cut out filling in the eyebrows because it's boring. I do the same with bathrooms because unless I'm doing something like special, I think it's pretty boring. You know, it's a toilet, it's a shower, maybe a bathtub and a sink, if that makes sense. But like I said earlier, it's so nice being creative again. Also, I wanted you guys to ask me some questions about The Sims and maybe not The Sims, to just digress here, to maybe get to know me a little bit better. So yeah, a little Q&A if you will. So here we go. From my lovely friend Pug owned on Twitter. If you want the best animals for your Sims, go check her out. She asked, am I left-handed or right-handed? Do I seem like a lefty? I've been told I seem like a lefty, but I am a righty. Do I like potatoes? Yes, Tate, I love them, but I barely get to eat them. My favorite childhood cartoon is a tough one. I love Daria with a passion, but Lilo and Stitch, the series, and The Simpsons. I love The Simpsons. How am I? I'm actually pretty good. Thanks for asking. How are you, psychic? How I got into The Sims. Okay, so my long-term good friend Lucy, I believe I went over to hers in like the fourth grade, so pretty darn young, and she showed me The Sims 2 on PlayStation. And so in turn, I begged my parents for it, and they packed a present for me when we went on school camp, and it was The Sims Apartment Life in the base game, I think, and I've been hooked absolutely ever since. Ready, Set, Go Sims has a few questions, so here we go. Oh my god, okay, dream pack or update. So I would just love a simple update that enabled Sims to chill on their beds, like relax and watch telly, like lay down. Who sits on the side of their bed? Or cuddle whilst they sleep, like they did in The Sims 3. I know I'm lame, but yeah, for a pack, okay, pretty much a bigger expansion of what parenthood had, so pretty much generations from The Sims 3. I love those little homey touches. It's pretty obvious with how I build. I am a big little detail lover, so I love that in my gameplay also. Okay, so a fun fact about myself. I don't really do this anymore, but I used to change my styles like every few months, from full-blown goth to hippy-dippy. I'm not even over-exaggerating. I love fashion no matter what it is. I also love the cultures behind fashion. At the moment, I'm pretty athleisure, and I found out I suit the color pink. So yeah, I love fashion. It's fun, and yeah, I like to reinvigorate myself every so often. The best thing about my baby boy Milo is that he is my new best friend. I've never been this close to an animal before, and it's really just sunnied up my life, and waking up to him being the little spoon is like the best thing ever. He honestly gives me so much happiness. A place I'd love to visit at the moment is Greece. I love Greek food, and it's so beautiful over there. Hidden talents. Okay, so ever since I learned to walk, I've been able to tippy-toe around, so full-blown ballerina feet. Yes, I also did ballet because it's kind of a given. But yeah, I didn't really like it. Funnily enough, my mum did the same when she was little. She literally could tiptoe on the skirting board next to the floor. Insane. Missing from Sims gameplay? That's a good question. So I've always tried to figure that out myself. I thought it might be nostalgia for the previous games, but I go back and I still genuinely enjoy them for what they are. The Sims 2 I love and The Sims 3 I love. And I actually played The Sims 4 in lib mode for around 3 years before just building. And I felt like the sizzle was there, but there was no steak, if you get me. Like, there's a lack of depth. And yeah, once again, I'm good. Thanks, ready, set, go, Sims. How many takes do I do during voiceovers? It depends on how confident I'm feeling. Usually only one, but I will say stuff over again if I feel like it wasn't said too clearly. I had to say that 2 times. Yeah. Do I speak any other languages? In college, I was definitely more confident in it, but I learned a decent chunk of German to at least hold some small talk and count. I also know most of the words to Rammstein songs, so does that count? Oh, and some Māori, so the New Zealand native tongue or native language, so Māori or Māori. My favourite subject in school was art. I'm a painter, artist, yada yada, and I also loved religion, so I'm not like religious, but I've always found them highly fascinating, and those classes were just super interesting. We learned about all kinds, and it was just like, I always love learning about things, and religion's been one of those things where I've just thought it's very interesting how they all came about and how they've influenced everything, whether it be good or not. But yeah, definitely 2 of my favorite classes. My favorite book. Okay, oh my god. So I struggled with reading for a very long time. I didn't actually know how to read properly till I was 10. I had to get a tutor. Her name was Shirley, and she was actually a retired fashion designer lady, and she was really cool. Long story there, but I read Let the Right One In by John Ajvid Lingvist. I don't know how to say his name. And I would read it all day, every day. Like, I'd walk with my nose in the book. I would be sitting in class with my nose in the book. It was like, and everyone kind of just let me do it. Like, the teachers were just like, okay, I've never seen her read before, so they just let me do it. I don't know. It was a weird 2 weeks of my life. So yeah, and I've just been wanting to read it again because it was so beautiful. If you're into a bit of horror and friendship, I suggest this novel. It has gorgeous imagery in the way he sets a scene. If you watch the movie, watch the Swedish version. And at the moment, I'm reading The Demonologist. If you've watched The Conjurings, it's the true story, take that with a grain of salt, about Ed and Lorraine Warren, the demon hunter people. Yes. My favourite and least favourite aspects of The Sims 4. Okay. So favourites, I love the building mechanics, obviously. Love, love, love them. It's a very aesthetically pleasing game, and in my opinion, it's aging pretty gracefully, presentation-wise. And least favourite thing is, yeah, like I said, the lack of depth, but I'm trying to learn to play more with a story in mind. See if that helps, I guess. Oh, yeah, and I also hate the oversized objects. And lastly, what kind of music do I listen to? And what artists are my favourites? Okay, so like, my choices in clothing, it's ever changing usually. So I love everything, really. I'm not actually into pop, to be honest, or what's generally mainstream at the moment. So I wasn't into a lot of like the One Directions, let's say, when I was growing up. I hated Justin Bieber, I'm sorry. I've always loved rock in most forms, and metal, punk, rap, anything. Like, I even like a bit of country. At the moment, my favorites, like band-wise, artist-wise, are Mother Mother, and they are, I guess, a unique kind of rock band. Kind of poppy, actually. If you give them a listen, totally listen to Hayloft. And my boyfriend got me into this rapper, and I'm absolutely in love with his stuff at the moment. His name's NF, but a long-term favourite of all time is Tech N9ne. Bet you weren't expecting that. But let's get back into the build and see what's happening. We're building the office now at the moment. This room I really struggled with. I was just kind of like, yeah, let's give it a blue, brown, and red theme. And then I went over the top and it was way too matchy-matchy, and then I ended up hating it. Oh, well, but it's good to like test things out, I guess, because sometimes you find a really good color scheme that you just kind of go, ooh, I like that. I'm gonna reuse that. And I tend to do that with a certain kind of room. I love the beds from City Living. And there's a particular blue swatch with like a light timber, and I always love that. And I think it goes so well with like the white wall and a blue wall. It just looks like very nice and clean and just a nice place to maybe like wake up. I don't know. It looks really like a relaxing kind of vibe, if you feel me. But yeah, I've built a couple things since I finished my last video, and then I realized, oh, whoa, university is out, like, really, really soon. What the fluff? So I had the idea of maybe a let's build, and I'm still kind of on the fence because I'm so used to speed builds, but I think it's time to let loose and have a little fun in different areas of The Sims. Oh, and oh my god, so you know how I've been super excited and talking about the new Let's Play series I've fallen in love with? Well, I finished the trailer, guys, and I love it so much. My friends love it too. I've picked out the music. I wanted to get one episode done before I release the trailer. And of course, after the university hype has like died down, because I don't know if it's going to be in the realm of gameplay possibilities, but we never know. You guys can always bring some ideas forth as well. I don't want it to just be like a you guys watch kind of scenario. But I also reckon the series might be a little bit heavy. If you watched Deligracy's series Hampton Falls, that's kind of what I want to do with my Let's Play. But anyway, back to what we were talking about before, the Let's Build series. What do you think we should do? Should we revamp the whole campuses or do a series of dorm rooms? Like say, we do a preppy version, then an edgy version or a more darkly inclined version. Also, who was just excited as heck for the mini fridges? And oh my god, I am so happy about the roommate system. This means we could build an apartment block, guys. Oh my god. Should we do a Let's Build of like a New York style apartment building with the stairs on the outside? We can make little hot dog cart on the outside. Oh my gosh, so many ideas. Oh, and on the whole Christmas thing right around the corner, I've decided I want to recreate the Home Alone house again because I loved what I did to it last time, but I think I can do better. And now we have configurable stairs and it's gonna be even better. And like, what other Christmas inspired build should we do? There is one already in the works, but that's a surprise for later. Keep your eyes peeled. But maybe something like The Nightmare Before Christmas or the movie Santa Claus. I love that. Always gonna make my boyfriend watch that with me. Oh yeah, it feels like this year has gone so fast and we just reached 1,400 subscribers. Oh my god, remember when we just hit 1k? A little while ago, thanks to the Edith Finch build. Absolutely marbles, guys. Just thank you so much. That means so much to me. But anyway, guys, I really hope you enjoy this video. I've missed you all so much and I've missed being creative. It's nice being back and trying new things like this mod and being able to finally do a diagonal wall that looks like, I guess, half realistic, I guess? But yeah, this build is up on the gallery, guys, under Jess Hearts. No CC or mods needed, but I suggest you download that mod, guys. It's amazing. Have a great day, and I'll see you guys next time. Oh yeah, subscribe and tick the bell if you want to see more builds. Bye!